Hello there, welcome. We will see how to create a professional page project with Adobe InDesign CC. If pronunciation is not good, leave feedbacks in comments. If you have problems, check the beginner tutorial in this show. Knowing the basics, let's start creating a professional page. We will take, for example, a page for a travel magazine, talking about New York. This page has all you need to know how to create any magazine page in InDesign. You can download the sample page in the video description. To create a single page, it's enough a single document. As seen in the previous video, you will collect all your pages later through an InDesign book. Go to File, New, and then to Document. Before going on, you must know which format the page must have. This depends on the size of the magazine. We will take, for example, the A3 print format. Don't worry about columns and all. You can adjust all later. You need to keep in mind the purple contour around the page. This represents the safe zone between the edges of the physical page and the parts that will be printed. The sample page we want to make is composed by two main parts: a graphic one that will contain any photo or image, and a text one where the article will be written. These will be set differently according to how the page design must be. The frame tool is used to save parts of the page that will welcome photos later. Simply choose the rectangle one and decide where to paste the photos. In this way, you will also locate where the text must spread. The frame box can be edited and moved, holding Ctrl down like a normal object. Then we can set the text. Activate the text tool through the T icon on the left. Then click and drag to create a text frame area. Inside this, you will type your text. So just create one for the photo description and another one for the article. While setting the text frame, you can use the arrows in your keyboard to add first rows and columns to arrange your text better. Small squares with a blue arrow inside will indicate you where the text is going on. Then you can start typing. Select the text frame interested, holding Ctrl down, and then click on Such to write in. You can copy and paste text too. You can manage the text frame size, holding Ctrl down. Make sure it is big enough to contain all. This won't change the size of the text. If you want to move the text later, simply move its frame box. You can move it carefully using the arrows in your keyboard. To understand better what frames are, check with a preview. Simply go to View and then to Overprint Preview. The frames are defining the parts of the pages dedicated to text or photos, but they still remain completely blank inside at first. Then adjust the text a little using the control panel on top. It is pretty used the big first letter at the beginning of the articles. Managing the text boxes is fundamental. If you have some overlapped, you need to select the right one before typing. You can hold the Ctrl down and select, or use the Layers window. Otherwise, you can use the Selection tool. This tool can be used to add further properties to the text box selected. For example, you can add some stroke or filling. Rule the columns inside or any size or rotation. On the right, how the paragraph inside must look up. All on top, at the bottom or distributed. You can apply these settings to more boxes, just select more of them holding Shift down. Manage the gaps between the boxes using the Gap tool. Another important step is to set the text distribution. With the text tool on, go in the extreme right. Choose how to distribute the text and the padding with the text frame container. You can even decide the indentation. Just remember to select the text box interested first and to do this step when the text content is fine. You can find more advanced options if you click on the paragraph symbol on the left. Let's now add our image. Simply press Ctrl and D to open the Place window. Then browse your photo and place it where you like. If it is placed auto, simply undo with Ctrl and Z and place again. When the image icon inside will be in two brackets, the image will be added inside the frame built. You may need to adjust it. Activate the selection tool to set the size of the box. Then hold the Ctrl down to adjust the image inside too. Drag the circle in the center to move the photo inside. Inside the articles, it is often shown a short sentence that highlights one of the topics. Create a new text frame and write inside the sentence that fixes the topic or a relevant aspect of what is written. Then you should put it in the page, but not overlapped, or the content can't be read. With the text box selected, activate the selection tool. The control panel above will have the wrap tools, which organize how overlappings must be treated. Choose the one you prefer. The treatment may change if you change the kind of corners that the text box selected must have. Make sure to add some distance between the topic sentence and the article. Another thing that can be done is to write some text overlapped to get attention. For example, we can write Discover NY in such a way that the article is still visible. Aside, create the text frame needed. Then drag it onto your project and mind not to use any wrap since you want all overlapped. Use the selection tool to add some transparency. Don't forget to add the page number in the corner. When it seems all done, check your project through a preview. Go to View and then to Overprint Preview. You can set the zoom holding Alt down and using your mouse wheel. This is all. Check the next video to know how to make a promo flyer as well. Bye!